My name is Rashmi Mandloi, and I lead the diversity function for BizDivas in South Asia. Women on Boards is a research and dream which has come true for all of us as a team, and we are really ecstatic to launch it in front of you today. So without further ado, let's kickstart the afternoon with Sarika. Sarika is the founder and the driving force behind BizDivas. Apart from Sarika being a great colleague...
It is true, a leader is someone who takes you where you want to be. But a woman leader is someone who takes you where you ought to be. BizDivas strives to create many such role models who will be at the helm of affairs in all walks of life. Women on Boards is such initiative which would help board-ready women and organizations to connect with each other.
We can show it to, in fact,
the you'll get to getting the copies.
All of you will be getting the copies. We can just have it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Maybe now.
Women quota. Correct. This is not a discussion or debate about that. This ought to be a discussion on governance. Does this improve governance? Does getting women on board change for better how a board would be governed? And there is sufficient research available. I'm just quoting one where clear evidence was found that women directors benefit organizational performance by bringing a different experience of work and wider life to decision making.
Yeah, absolutely. I think the change is there, whether it is now the new government or whether we look at the new metro system in Mumbai or whether we look at the express. I think how rapidly this change is going to end, again, whether India Inc. is built, what is India Inc. going to do?
Well, I would say that SEBI timelines came very suddenly of 1st October. Let me put it very bluntly that I am personally opposed to any kind of reservations. I think what has happened is that the moment you create a reservation or a quota, some of the most eligible and eminent women who are joining our boards are being perceived as coming under a quota system, which is very, very demeaning. You know, the persons are very eligible in their own right because of variety of historical, socio-cultural factors in India and elsewhere in the world also, that they have not been on the board. And they come and then find that, oh, there is an amendment to the Companies Act or there's a clause 49 of the listing agreement because of which they are coming. So that's an issue. As far as we are concerned, we started the journey well in advance, and some of our boards, we have more than one women.
In fact, the issue that
most of the corporations today, for example, Tata Group has the same philosophy. A full-time employee at an executive director level or anywhere cannot accept any outside Tata directorships. And it's only with a special permission, and generally the such permissions are not granted. So a very high talent, quality talent pool is not available.
They are referring to paucity of talent in the case of women. But generally speaking, what I've found that today there are even men who are very hesitant to take up board positions because of the associated liability and the general raison bar, the ask of the board, right? So unless and until corporations are open to the fact that, let's say, for their senior people, they will be open for them to go out and become non-exec directors, independent directors, I think it's going to be a challenge, and it will be a smaller set of people that will be available because of this. And if I look at the SEBI guidelines on the caps they have imposed, and if I look at the number of companies that have to fulfill this requirement, I think there is a big gap. So the trend that, you know, one has already begun to see is, as a result, you're also seeing misuse. And I would absolutely agree that, quota is a bad way of looking at it, because quota will drive down the standard, not drive
That's
up the standard.
Because the research report again mentions the fact that visibility, networking, and sponsorship opportunities for women is something which is lacking many a times, or they are not investing in it enough for them to be visible enough to be eligible or to be considered.
So cycle change is needed from where we are, whatever you say. We are still a very highly patriarchal society, male dominated, and that shift has to come. It is in some of the corporates, it is coming, and as
Bharat very rightly said that when you go to the next level of unlisted companies, it's in fact, Bharat, I had not even realized what you mentioned, and I'm just sitting here and really just can't even imagine what kind of boards and what kind of people they would have on those boards. 100 crore and a 300 crore turnover public company.
The other important thing that board members bring is because they sit on multiple boards, see multiple businesses, they cross-pollinate the experience, and I find the cross-pollination of experience immensely valuable. Because as a CEO running one business, you only see your business. You see only your business problems. You only know about your company, your industry, your tax issues, and so on. If you have people on the board who bring a diversity of experience, they're able to throw light, they're able to share perspective, they're able to unentangle you from your problems in very interesting and creative ways. Because you are in that tunnel, you just can't find your own solution, whereas the board members can, you know, kind of really
that
help.
When women get an opportunity, when they get a seat on the table, they make room for others. And their voice speaks for so many other women, as we saw from our distinguished speakers here today. I would like to thank the speakers for today, Bharat Doshi, Ashish Shriyas, Bharat Vasani, Ravi Kulkarni, and lastly, Renu Paramnath.